One of the vast advantages that the Federation has over Cascadia is their absolute control and logistics routes. Factories in states that we can't even touch are pumping out equipment and supplies for them at a pace we'll never be able to match. However, they all have to get in the country somehow. The Federation supply train is one carried out mostly by air, now that the eminent domain is intercepting cargo ships coming into Federation ports. Civilian traffic has remained largely the same thanks to Federation communication protocols. The reality of this conflict has been kept hidden, courtesy of the Solana communication facility in the Aitor Desert. This mission is as follows. Mercenary and allied pilots will be dispatched to various points along the airways, knocking out Federation logistics aircraft and grinding their resupply efforts to a halt. By striking in broad daylight, we can openly challenge the Federation when they think they're safe. Remember, it's imperative that no civilians are harmed in this operation, so engage carefully.
Careful's my last name, and safety's my mom. Let's go, Monarch. I'd like to touch down before lunch.
Kill us all! transmitted by Federation military call signs. Monarch missile on the way. Positive hits, he's going down. Why would the Feds send us up if they're expecting something like this? Pin him down. War contained my ass.
Away. What are we doing with the two of five super heavies? We've seen them. missile is on the way. Missile is on the way.
Thank you.
The intercept operation was a success. Worldwide, news is breaking out about the Independence Force's calculated and precise presence on the international stage. No civilian casualties have been reported, and the Federation, while dealing with the disruption of their air train, have to contend with international response to the war. Hitman 1, your flight was the most successful of these intercepts, and the Federation is currently scrambling to find alternative ways to maintain logistics.
Monarch, this is an op just for you. You know I don't like admitting this, but mercenary pilots in this world are among some of the best. They get more airtime, more time on target, than any of us national pilots outside of the periphery. In truth, you get the glamour we all thought fighter pilots were supposed to have when signing up to the Academy. That, and you're making 5 times what I make in a year. I wonder if that's why you went private, but I don't think you're the type to give that answer. Not to me, anyway. What I'm trying to say is, you're capable, more capable than most, getting this far in. And because of that, we need you on deck for a one-man mission.
Cascadia's southeastern deserts hosts the Solana Communication Array. It was a Federation and Cascadian telecom venture meant to expand Cascadia's networking capability, regardless of any thermal interference that traditionally plagues long-range communications. With that facility, communications between various Federation units are streamlined, while limiting jamming and interrupting our own. Nothing to say of the censorship abilities that are used to enforce the civilian information flow. This is one of the Independence Force's top targets. However, it's been outside our strike range until now. Due to its distance from our front lines, no fuel can be wasted dodging or circumventing Federation anti-air systems en route. In short, we're sending you alone to clear up the most disruptive defense systems before we engage in a full-scale operation to knock out the facility. You will insert into the Kaohor defense region in the Raver Mountains and take out all critical defense systems under cover of night. The defense system is calibrated for mass aerial strikes, but a lone aircraft flying relatively level with the mountains should be able to slip through and take them out. Dismissed.
Monarch, the radar defenses are pretty hidden away on the mountain range, but your pal Galaxy got them all marked out. After this mission, don't tell me I never do anything for you.
Locking on to you.
locating them Bravo through Golf as we get them. You know, Monarch, I've heard a lot about why you three joined. Hitman, that is. Comic had her wings clipped, Dip was told he wasn't good enough to fly out of the Academy, and you came in with him. My question, though, is what are you all looking for after all this time? You've made your fortunes, and lost them, so many times these last few years. So what else is there, huh? Monarch, never mind. It ain't like you're gonna tell me tonight.
Tertiary systems.
How many?
ready to fire. Monarch, miss a shot. Nice kill! Monarch, the enemy's locking onto you. Monarch, opening fire. Incoming missile, Jake. Stacked up. Positive tone. Missile shot off.
I almost feel bad, Monarch, for making you come with us tomorrow to hit that communication facility. Especially after what you pulled off tonight, single-handedly. Though that was one hell of a thing you did. And I got a feeling Operation Blackout will need you on point. We have a straight shot to Cascadia's southeast. And, with any luck, we'll have fuel to spare for the fight. Sicario is mobilizing en masse tomorrow morning. Get some sleep. This war isn't gonna win itself.
There's nothing much I need to say to you, Sicario. Operation Blackout will be conducted entirely by you. I cannot, however, express enough how important this strike is. Commander, you have the floor.
The Ator Desert has hosted the Solana Communication Array for the greater part of the decade. It was a Federation project in-country that was meant to boost and maintain the communications infrastructure of Cascadia. However, during the war, it has served as a jamming and communication facility. The very basis of a unified command structure is built on the pillars of communication. If we take out this facility, it'll be like yanking the rug out right from beneath their feet. The facility is heavily defended, hosting an airbase and a ground garrison on its own. The only way we're getting boots on the ground is via a mass airdrop, followed by relentless close air support from our fighter group until the entire place is overrun. It's as simple as that. Now normally, the Independence Force would be offering some assistance, but they can't afford that now. Under any other pretense, this is a suicide mission. Even with the air corridor Monarch cleared up, there's only enough fuel for a one-way trip. So the only way we're coming back is if we take the adjoining airbase after we hit the facility. Expect heavy air and ground resistance. Pillboxes, tanks, AA, airships, the whole shebang. If we pull this off, well, let's just say we'll be handsomely rewarded. Gold or glory, gentlemen. Get to your plates. The Cascadians call this place the Devil's Sandbox. So what does that mean if we're the ones playing in it, huh? Let's go.
Galaxy Wall Sicario Armaments, we're going for Operation Blackout. Total destruction of the enemy communication facilities are our prime objective for this operation. Cover Circus and destroy any base defenses before they deliver the ground forces to the DZ.
Over to you, boss.
This is the largest deployment in our history as a mercenary group. The Independence Force put a lot of faith in us for this operation. Let's not disappoint.
So I guess that also means you're still out there, right?
I wish I could say the same. Okay, all flights? Looks like the enemy defenses aren't the only issue now. We have bogeys inbound from the north toward our transports. That means you, Hitman. Intercept and engage.
Back off, Galaxy. We're going, we're going.
About time. Comic engaging.
Confirmed rebel forces crossing into our airspace.
I've got a visual on a non-uniform flight formation and transport aircraft.
Two forces this far in?
Monarch ready to fire.
Anything here. Deploy what we have.
Come on, the other defense squadrons are on the track. airfield is ours. Console 6 and 7, cover the circus until reassigned.
Copy that, Galaxy.
Hitman flight. Reassigned to air-land battle. Search and destroy targets of opportunity at will. Securing battle space as our ground forces get set for the attack on the main facilities.
Roco, Galaxy.
Come on, Monarch. We're free range now.
Comic buys.
Hey, how about you have a flight?
sail, but not all. And we've got incoming fighters and gunships. Watch it.
This is Captain Kelleher. Go and seize the command center now. Going dark.
Good work, cowboy.
Sicario, we have our ringtone. Commence attack.
Designating new targets and HVTs on the IFF. Have at it.
Thank you.
ground units. Confirm?
Yeah, I see the smoke, Galaxy.
This is well and actual. We've seized the tower and put out an all clear on the Federation comms.
I think we're running gas. We should be clear until the next update schedule in an hour.
Good work today, people.
All damaged aircraft land until repairs is needed. If you can't, just take one of their planes.
Ground forces, smash and grab anything worth it, and await pickup by Circus. Let's not overstay our welcome.
This is the Circus. We're coming in.
Alright, pick up what you need to get out of here. We can celebrate when we're back at Rose Dower.
All pilots, listen up. I'm getting in my plane right now. So when this briefing is done, I expect to see all of you running.
All Allied air power not currently predisposed in other operations are to be scrambled immediately and make their way to the Bering Strait. In the days since the destruction of the Solana communication relay, the Federation has been disorganized and subject to our own electronic warfare countermeasures. It is because of this, our first conventional victories up and down the front lines are being reported, and the Federation is dealing with losses it hasn't had to deal with in decades. Recently, in order to improve individual unit combat effectiveness, the Federation has been discharging Cascadian manned units and replaced them with soldiers who aren't nationals. Subsequently, many of our once misguided countrymen have defected and are providing us with invaluable intel and manpower. Earlier today, one of our patrols caught a group of transports using the cover of an Arctic storm to get unorganized and underpowered Federation units out of Cascadia, probably to regroup and redeploy later. The patrol engaged, and the Federation sent more fighters to cover them. Seeing as these transports represent the bulk of Federation forces who have experience fighting us, we did not want them to regroup, so we sent more reinforcements. Squadron leaders and base commanders on both their side and ours have been escalating force deployment ever since combat began. High-profile squadrons and our forces and theirs are currently present. The snowball effect, however, has inadvertently created, by all accounts, what is turning out to be the most expansive aerial battle in the war thus far, and is steadily falling out of control. We cannot let the Federation have any more of their forces escape and regroup, even if it means the largest furball in history.
Flashing eyes. come down. You're in gun range.
Keep fighting. You've still got bogeys.
Don't drop your guard. The Federation always has more.
We've got inbound. Pop up band to group of band 230. Looks like they pulled back for one last push. There's a lot of them. IFF confirmed. Federation Peacekeeping Squadron Crimson identified with more reinforcements. This is it.
Ah, shit. Crimson Squadron, ready the MRAs. We're putting an end to this party. Looks like it's those mercenaries. Think they might turn tail and run again? Not this time. Open fire. Enemy's walking live. Break! Mark 2, Mark 2! Radar
The full fury of Federation air power was unleashed today over the Bering Strait. And miraculously, thanks to the actions of the Hitman team, we have not only survived it, but bested it. The Federation's force projection capabilities will be heavily decreased now that their air support across the theater has been effectively decimated at the moment. It'll take some time for them to shore up more pilots from their vassal states, but for now, we have the total advantage. All that remains for them, then, is their airships. But we're drafting up a plan to deal with them now. Until your next orders, get some rest and expect a little bonus. We couldn't get an exact count of how many fighters you downed today, but we'll just round up and call it fair.